Hello and welcome to another trip report. This time I'll be taking the ICE train, which stands for Intercity Express, from Cologne, so Köln Hauptbahnhof, Cologne main station in Germany, direction Munich, so München, which is in the south of Germany. This is one of the newer type ICE trains. It can't go 300 kilometers per hour. It goes a little bit slower, maximum 250 kilometers per hour. But there is a huge capacity for passengers, and this train also takes bikes. Anyway, I hope you enjoy the video. Just like many other videos, I will start with a quick comparison on this route when you're traveling by train, car and plane. Well, trains won't clean the air, but still the environmental impact is a lot less than when you're traveling by car and especially by plane. This is the Cathedral of Cologne. And this is the Railway Cathedral of Cologne. You probably witnessed the worst intro I ever did on a video. Anyway, the Cathedral of Cologne is absolutely stunning, and when you have time over when you need to change trains here or when you start your journey, I really advise you to take a visit at this place. When you're, just like me, into contemporary art, I really advise you to pay a visit at this museum. It's also located next to the railway station. Actually, this railway station is really central located. It's right in the old city center. From here you can walk to pretty much all highlights within the old city of Cologne. In the main hall on the front part of the railway station you'll find the information desk, and here's also a big screen with information about departing trains. Well, information is provided really well throughout the station, I'll show you in a bit. Köln Hauptbahnhof, or Cologne main station, is an important local, national and international transport hub. Many ICE and Thalys high-speed trains do stop here, both national ICE trains and international ICE trains. Well, Thalys trains are always international. And besides that, lots of intercity and Eurocity trains do stop here as well. Of course, lots of local trains will call at this station as well, both the S-Bahn trains and, well, regional trains. Below the railway station you'll find the underground station. Well, the underground is not only for Cologne, this will be connected with Bonn, for example, as well, the former capital of Western Germany. Within the railway station you'll find a hotel, and next to the hotel entrance in the main hall you'll find lots of car rental companies. This is also close to the Reisezentrum, which stands for Travel Center. Here you can buy tickets. In the middle of the railway station you'll find lots of fast food restaurants. And within the station you will find lots of shops in general, for example drugstores, but surprisingly also quite a lot of fashion related shops. It's not a bad place when you have to wait when you have to change trains. This railway station serves approximately 300,000 passengers each day. Directions are clearly given throughout the station. They use a lot of icons, so it's easy for everyone to understand. Another thing you'll find throughout the station are digital departure screens. At the beginning of each platform you'll find a big screen which says when the next trains will depart and where to. At platform 1 you'll find a DB lounge for first class passengers. Not all first class tickets will give you access, so please check the restrictions on your ticket. Next to the DB lounge you'll find another waiting room called Reisepause, literally translated travel break. This is also a warm place where you can sit and, well, wait for your train. From here you can look at the first class lounge, and people from the first class lounge can look back. This small waiting room is open 24 hours a day. At each platform you'll find digital screens that will give train information about departing trains. And of course, like pretty much everywhere in the world, you also have big screens at each platform which gives information about each train. Also a small train composition will be displayed here. Another thing where you can find the train composition is at the screens at the platform. Well, this is not digital, so when something changes it won't be up to date here. But yeah, in general this works pretty fine in Germany. Time to show you the train instead of the station.
Station
Today I'll be traveling on an ICE Type 4 with a capacity of 830 passengers and 8 bicycles. The top speed is 250 km per hour. Code numbers can be found at the side of each train, both permanent and on a digital screen. The digital screen also says the train number and the destination of the train. The class numbers can also be found at the side of each train. Throughout the train, you will find lots of digital screens in the compartments. Well, these screens will give you route information like speed, time, but also where the train is at this moment. Station announcements will be made here as well. Between the carriages, you also find lots of screens with route information. All information is in German, English and French. Free Wi-Fi is provided in this train, and in the Wi-Fi system, all detailed route information will be displayed here as well. You'll also find an entertainment system here. As you just saw, the train had a little delay on the route, but eventually it was on time in Munich. The second class will come in a 2x2 configuration, so two seats on both sides of the aisle. All seats, except for the compartment when you're traveling with young children, will come in an open coach, like you can see here. On the side of each chair, you find the seat numbers and also the reservations are written here. Between some chairs, you'll find some extra space for your luggage. All chairs can be reclined, as you can see here, and you can find the reclining button right under your chair. This is also where you find the power plug. In the second class, there's one power plug per two chairs. Most seats come in a composition like this, and you'll find a small fold-out table. I do have to say, this is a kind of small and I'm kind of disappointed by this. You'll also find a garbage can between the chairs in front of you, and there's a small magazine rack as well. In the front or the back of the train, depending which way you go, you'll find a space like this. And right behind it, you'll find the space for bicycles. When you're traveling with a bike on this train, you're obligated to make a bike reservation. This is the compartment for when you're traveling with young children, so the family compartment. Throughout the train, you'll find lots of space for your luggage. You have lots of luggage racks and, of course, you can use the overhead luggage racks as well. I really like it that the luggage racks are in the middle of the carriages and not at the end, so you can have a closer look at your luggage. You'll also find a dining car, and one part you'll find a kiosk like you just saw, and the other part it's more like a restaurant, as you can see here. Well, as you may be known from my previous videos, I'm a huge fan of dining cars. I really like this, and the menu on German trains is relatively good. The menu will give you more options than, for example, trains in France and Spain. The dining car is located between the first and the second class. The first class comes in a 1x2 configuration, so one seat on one side of the aisle and two seats on the other side of the aisle. You just have more space, but it won't give you that much extra service, except from a newspaper and a chocolate. Just like in the second class, the seat numbers can be found at the side of the chairs, and a digital display will tell you from where to where the seats have been reserved. As you can see here, you have a lot more leg space, and one thing I missed in the second class, you'll find a small footrest. The tables are just as small as in the second class. Another thing you won't find in the second class is a reading light. And all chairs do have their own power plug in first class. All seats can be reclined with a handle under the chairs. And all armrests can be put in upright position, except for the ones next to the windows. Well, this is basically the same in second class. By the way, all windows do have sunscreens, both in first, second class and the dining car. Except for the toilet for disabled people, the toilets are not very big, but they're fine and they were kept pretty clean during the way. From here, I'll show you some views I had from the train. The top speed might only be 250 km per hour, but this train can accelerate really fast. Wake up, step into the world outside. The future never looks so bright. Can't you hear it calling us? Let go. Run away, 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 away. We don't have to stay.
Let's go. Dive into the deep blue sky. Come with me to paradise. Can't you hear it calling us?
Can't you hear it calling us? Calling us.
Dreaming of tomorrow, soaking up the sun. We can go and find the magic. Yeah, we could run.
Railway station. I hope you like this video, and when you like it, please give me a thumbs up. And when you'd like to see more trip reports by train, as always, subscribe to my channel. See you on my next video.